Lord is good. He's been good to you. As much as you let him. That's what this meeting is about, to let God be more good to you. He want to do some more things for you. You got to learn how to participate, how to flow, how to cooperate, how to yield. Yeah, the Lord want to do something else for you. You know that, right? That's why we're here. To open up to let God do more in our lives. Use us more. I'm thankful, you know, I've been trained in this business by some of the greatest. Brother Roberts, I thought about him. He's gone home to be with the Lord. He would stay in the back and pray until God tell him something. Or he won't come out. He tell him, keep singing. He wouldn't come out until he heard from God. On the other hand, Dr. Price don't really need no singing. He got his mind made up. He prayed and got before God, and he coming out, and he going to teach his lesson. Now, my dad, who trained me, he trained me to flow in the spirit. And he would sometimes say, let's sing another song. I'd watch him for many years as ways to bring cooperation of the Holy Ghost. When the Holy Ghost is in a meeting, functioning as he desire, everyone can get the answer. So I would ask you to say thank God for the Holy Ghost. Because he's the one revealed things to us. Actually, Jesus prayed with thanksgiving only. He already knew what belonged to him. So he always said, thank you. No matter what the condition was. I know I'm thinking of when it was a provisional prayer, when he had the 5,000, he didn't ask to multiply the bread. He said something like, I thank you. You always hear me. Well, he knew that was in him, you see. Even at the provision at the point of death, when Lazarus had died, when he got to Lazarus' grave, he didn't ask the Lord to raise Lazarus. He said, thank you, Father, you always hear me. Get up, Lazarus. And I'm using that introduction to let you know we began this morning, and it's Friday this morning. So this Friday night, every day going to be Friday. Because there's enough insight in the Word of God, in the spirit realm, that you can take a hold of your life fully in one moment. Now, you may be seated. Our golden text is Ephesians 1:3. Because this text describes Ephesians chapter 1, verse 3. This text describes or reveal that prosperity is already yours. But you must denote that it began in the spiritual realm. Let me form around a little bit. Let me form around. It's in the spirit realm. It's there. It's yours. At the new birth. Prosperity is part of the salvation package. Abundance. Wealth, increase. All, every child of God is already yours.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. All right. Yes,
sir. I want to say this in a way. Let me read this verse and say it in a way I combined two verses that I never had combined before, Ephesians 1:3 and Ephesians 3:20. 1 and 3 said, blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has, blessed us. And you know, blessed means empowered to prosper. Now, it's not God's fault if you don't use your empowerment. Who has blessed us with all spiritual blessing. Now you see, that word spiritual blessing is athoia. You have the divine ability to convert spiritual blessings into material blessing. Or into manifestation. Or into withdrawal. The hardest thing any man has ever done is trying to get God to do something that he has already done. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So God just said, then look at him. Go back, he says, you need another teacher. Yes, sir. You have not been taught what you already have. And you're trying to get it when you should be activating it. Now, you know, we've come down hundreds of years with this prosperity stuff. And most people in the body of Christ still don't have what you call real prosperity. I'm talking about, wipe my lip, real prosperity. Spendable. Not just a confession, but a possession of prosperity. And so you know the scripture said, now unto him that is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think. Then he goes on and said, according to the power that worketh in you. Now, there are two distinct power on the inside of you, your spirit and your soul. They're both on the inside. One on the inside can jive around your soul unless you take a hold of it, renew it, and enlighten it that it can connect with the part inside of you that knows everything, that has everything, and that can cause everything that all the promises of God become yea and amen through that channel of the spirit of God that live on the inside of you. So tonight we want to unfolding the mysteries of prosperity that is already yours. Unfolding the mystery of prosperity that is already in you. See, I believe that's what we've been missing at. You see, we have thought that you get this book, read this book, make this statement, make this affirmation, make this decree, make this confession. But there's a participation here. There's a partnership here. Huh? You have to get to the point where you have only one soul. One supplier. Who can produce with your partnership many channels. Yes, right. You heard me? Yes, one source, one supplier, and producing many channels. If you don't lack your finances, change station. Why you keep watching channel 2 when you know it's happening on channel 9? Actually, I revealed to you some 23 channels. Actually, tonight I have 26 channels you can turn on, and you will be tuned in to prosperity. If it's not on one channel, that channel looks like it wasn't good that day, just turn to another one. You have 26 activators of prosperity on the inside of you. It's more. You got 26 triggers you can pull. And so I want to recall all of these prosperity potentials that you have on the inside of you and still go without it. This week, I am to change that personality. On the inside of you, that you can walk into prosperity freely and receive what is rightfully yours. One of the activators was his likeness. I'm in his likeness. Are you in his likeness? Are you saved? You're in his likeness. That's a prosperity activator. If I'm like God, connected to God, I don't see God no way out of prosperity. So I can take that likeness that I have of God and activate prosperity in my life. See, it's not a spirit problem. Prosperity is not a spiritual problem. It's a soulish problem. Wonder, was or is God rich? I wonder if there ever was a time that God was not rich. I wonder if there's some economic crisis can come and call God to drop to another scale. You just like him. In him, I live, I move, and I have my being. Image, second activator. Image. Now, most Christians are not operating in prosperity because they're suffering from a persecuted soul. The enemy, that's Psalm 145. 143, somewhere along the line. Turn there a minute. I don't know, I got ahead of myself, but that's all right. I'm just going to search with the Holy Ghost tonight for a few moments. But I know you want your answer. And you just say, search on, Apostle. I'm still here. Yes. Search on. Because we have to yield to the Holy Ghost. But there's a way the enemy... I say to you this morning, those of you who are here, that the enemy cannot outright steal from you. He has to trick you in your soul. And he's a trickster, a defeated trickster. That even make it worse. I want to begin reading, and I'm just trying to follow the Holy Ghost. I got a lot more things to say. Even though it's Friday, but you had Psalm 143. Yes, sir. If the Holy Spirit can get us to see tonight, because it's sad because we come to meeting, and you know we expect some emotional excitement, but yet you should expect change. This is God's word. We have assembled in God's name. That's why I'm not here fussing at you. I didn't come to fuss and cuss at you. I came to put revelation out. Yes. that you might leave this meeting tonight changed. With an understanding, I don't care how long you've been going through this, but with revelation and connection and understanding, I can change this thing. Listen, it's already changing one part of you. If I could connect with that part properly, all my past damage will be repaired. Do you understand what I'm saying? Now, we're far beyond just having a meeting. Any moment, any second in this house, something can happen that will change your position in life forever. Help me, Holy Ghost. Help me, Holy Ghost. Say it, help me, Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is the prosperity filler. He loves to bring a person out of lack and limitation to the unlimitedness of his status. I was reading in this 143rd Psalm, and I want to read a scripture that may, and I'm going to bring you some more of these witnesses in a few minutes, these activators, this evidence, this proof that prosperity is already yours. I have to show you how to use these activators. I gave you one, likeness. You made in his likeness? Huh? Is he broke? Has he shared his inheritance with you? Is silver and gold a part of his inheritance? So you ought to have plenty of it. See, you don't have to pursue money. I pursue who I am in him. In the fourth verse of this psalm, I was reading this. And he says, therefore is my what?
Spirit.
Therefore is my what?
Spirit.
What?
Lord.
How can that be within me? My heart, my soul within me is desolate. That's why my spirit overwhelmed. My spirit is overwhelmed because my soul don't have the capacity to maintain or obtain what I want to put in it. Your spirit is always on the way to manifestation. So those of us who cannot reach our prosperity proper, our soul is desolate.
Yes, sir. Come on, Apostle. Yes, sir.
For lack of a better word, our soul is looking on the wrong side of the coin.
All right.
Our soul is leaning more to our senses and the system than to our spirit. Our soul is listening to the news. And the spirit is screaming good news. You're not in that system no more. Don't pay no attention to that. They're not talking to you. Turn around. You're looking the wrong way. You must suffer from no crisis. Apostle John in 3 John 2 said, beloved, we quote this scripture, beloved, I wish of all things you prosper and be in health, even as your soul prospers. You know, for a long time, I know in the Baptist church, still is. They think the spirit and the soul are the same thing. Now, that's a confusing matter, because now I don't know where my problem at. You see what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
So when you get to the scripture, like Hebrews 4:12 and 1 Thessalonians 5:23 and Romans 12:1-3, you see that's different. The soul and the spirit are not the same. What could make your spirit overwhelmed? Because I can't get to you what is rightfully yours. So you can live the lifestyle God wants you to live in this earth's realm by receiving manifestation and demonstration from the Holy Ghost of what is properly yours in your covenant. Your soul keep turning it down. Your soul keep turning it around. Because the enemy has persecuted your soul with religion. And all those spirits are not going out your soul yet. They're still rising back up. When the Bible talks about prosperity in the Old Testament, the 23rd Psalm is a prosperity psalm. It says, it's talking about a prepared table and a covering over. He said, and he restores my soul. Because my soul can mess this whole prepared table up. And can mess this cup up and everything. So if your soul can't handle it, you can't have it. Because an untrained soul with prosperity will become the devil's workshop. So while most Christians do not have plenty of money or have the money that do them, is because they haven't worked on their soul enough. So we're going to do something about it. Let me give it to you another way. Lackness is a prosperity key that you can unlock your soul with. Image is a prosperity key. You got 26 keys, 26 activators. Tonight, you might have more before you leave. You might have 100. Because I want you to see all the ways. See, here's a psalm. Now, let's go back. Let's read back. Psalm 143, verse 3. For the enemy has persecuted my soul. He has smitten my life down to the ground. Oh my goodness. Down to the ground. He has made me to dwell in darkness, as those that have been long dead. So that's a lot of dead folks in prosperity. They are alive to God and dead to prosperity. And there are some who argue with you about prosperity. They're so religiously proud, and they don't know their soul is drowning in darkness, doubt, and unbelief, and the enemy is holding them back from what God rightly wants. They read the scripture. But God cannot manifest your prosperity without your partnership, without your participation. Look at verse 10. This psalm teaches a lot of things. Teach me to do thy will, for thou art my God. Thy spirit is good. Lead me to the land of uprightness. Your spirit wants you to have it. It's your mind tripping. Look at verse 11. Everybody here who have financial your problem, your soul is in trouble.
Yes, sir.
It's only soul trouble, baby. Tell somebody next to you. Tell them it's only soul trouble, baby. So let the apostle walk you out of it. Don't get too proud up in here. It's only soul trouble. It's not your neighbor. It's not nobody, your boss. It's not nobody else. It's only soul trouble you got. You mean to tell me I've been going through all this, all these years, and all I got is soul trouble? Yes. And do you mean I could correct it right now? Yes. He says, as your soul prospers. Well, a persecuted soul can't prosper. Afflicted soul can't prosper. A troubled soul can't prosper. I remember Ben Clenshaw. How you say his name?
Clenshaw.
I'm preaching for David down at another church he was helping. I preached for about 20, 25 minutes. Ben grabbed his head and went down on the floor. He said, I can't take no more. And been around religious all his life. I could tell you some other things to know about the condition, why he grabbed his head, but I won't do that. You just believe. People be around God, don't even know God want them wealthy. I don't have no trouble with money, me. No, I'm money my friend. Many people have made money their enemy by improper teaching. Money my friend. See, some of y'all scared to say it. God ain't, you ain't gonna drop dead. God ain't gonna kill you. God trying to get something to you. That's why I'm with God. God sent me. The Bible says, make friend with mammon. With a constipated and a blind soul, you're not going to ever walk in prosperity. See, religion does not minister to your spirit. Religion ministers to your soul. The wrong stuff. We have come through some stuff. I said we have come through some stuff. You're not a delivered slave until you walk in prosperity. Eleven verse says, quicken me, O Lord, for thy name's sake, for thy righteousness' sake. Bring my soul out of trouble. Bring my soul. Say it.
Bring my soul out of trouble.
You don't have no money problem. You got a soul problem. You got to save that soul every day. Ha! I got scripture now. You know, I got scripture. And you don't go saying nothing. You ain't got no scripture for it. You can't be saying that if you don't have no scripture for it. When you bring salvation to your soul with the engrafted word, it connects with your spirit, open the valve, and let the glory and the power come through. I'll take you to that scripture in a minute. Look at verse 12. And of thy mercy, cut off my enemies and destroy all them that afflict my soul, for I am thy servant. Let me show you something else now. Go right over to the 139th Psalm. May I work here a minute, Lord. May the Holy Spirit help me, Holy Spirit. How many have seen me? Some of y'all ain't seen nothing. I've been up here. I've been up here laboring, man. You don't raise the hand, you don't see nothing. The soul afflicted, the soul persecuted, the spirit overwhelmed, the heart, the soul desolated and ruined because they can't receive what God had prepared for them. And I asked, did anybody see anything? He said, a few of them hold their hand up. What is this? You listening? Listen, you done had enough emotion for this year. You got to stop dreaming about a white Christmas and have a white Christmas. I'm tired of all these symbols. I want the real thing. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I'm actually tired of all these confessions. Yes, I need to see some manifestation and demonstration and creation. I don't need to keep talking about this stuff. I need to wear this stuff. Yes, I need to ride in and sleep in it. You ever thought a country boy can fly in a $20 million jet and tell it what way to turn in the air? I'm the boss. I could be headed to New York. I believe I won't go to Chicago. They got to do what I tell them to do. First should be last. The last should be first. In teaching on health, which is another aspect of prosperity, they correlate. Health is a part of salvation. Another soul issue. Because your body follow your soul. Your manifestation follow your soul. See, it's either two against one. It's either your soul and your body against your spirit, or your spirit and soul against your body. When I read this, I knew it was a day. In the 14th verse of 139 Psalm, I will praise thee, for I'm fearfully and wonderfully made. Now, I didn't get up here to talk about none of this. I'm fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are thy work. Now, that last statement is talking about help, but think the same way about prosperity. And my soul knoweth right well. That is right there. If your soul knows right well, if your mind, your emotion, your imagination, your consciousness knows right well that prosperity belongs to you, that is. See, it's not coming through to your body and to all your outward affairs. More than you can handle. All right, I'll get back to that soul later. I'll show you the way we did graft the word sometime this week. But put those 26 up there. I don't know how many can get up there, so they can write. Write. John said write. put some up there so they can see them. Because I want you to know, at any given moment, I'm made in his likeness. Keep rolling them. Just keep rolling them. Image. Keep rolling them. New creature. Roll. I'm a son, a daughter, a son of God. All right. Roll it. I'm a kingdom citizen. Roll it. I'm a partaker of his divine nature. Hold it. Hold it right there. Either one of them. You see, you don't have them. You didn't get them? Either one of them, you can activate your prosperity. Oh. If you by faith continue to say to the Lord, I'm your son. Your prosperity belongs to me. Your soul gonna catch on. You call that renewing the mind. I'm a partaker of his divine nature. Where them folks at? Where them folks that I use? Stand up. You remember who you are? What you who?
I am son of God, kingdom citizen.
Citizen.
Like.
Inheritance.
Son of God.
Partaker of his divine nature. Abundance and righteousness of God. Supernatural being. In the name of Jesus. I have to raise
my faith.
Sir. New creature.
Ma'am. Filled with his glory. Y'all talk loud.
I'm a spirit. I have a soul and I live in a body.
I'm blessed. Well.
I got everybody standing?
Yeah. Prosperity.
Prosperity. Now that's how many that is. Count it. How many that is? One. Count it, somebody. Count them, David. Nineteen? Huh?
Yes, sir.
That's you.
Increase.
Increase, all right. That's you.
Thank you.
What? What? Somebody say something else? That's you. Everyone of these persons standing, that's you.
Yes.
Every one of these persons standing, they are prosperity activators.
Yes,
sir.
You can argue your case that I'm a partaker of your divine nature. You can convert your soul with scriptures that reveal that you're a partaker of his divine nature, and that valve has to come open. You can argue your case, I'm a new creature, long enough, and that valve got to come open. You may be seated. Let me go down the list right quick. Partake of his divine nature. Go, keep going, girl. It's so important. I'm a spirit. I have a soul to live in the body. Is that right?
Yes,
all right. Wait a minute. I'm a spirit. I have a soul. I have a soul. I have a contrary soul unless I train it to come in agreement and alignment with me, the spirit. We who are prosperous because we are Christian have taken our mind and body and tried to become prosperous in the world system. Oh, I don't be able to go to Jordan. I'm a son. I'm a kingdom citizen. I'm a partaker of divine nature. I'm a spirit of heaven, soul, living in the body. I operate by faith. I call things that be not as though they were, because they are. I'm living in grace. Listen, because I'm going to add a few more on to it. Then I'm going to go on. I'm filled with his glory. I'm a supernatural being. I got the name of Jesus. I'm using the word of God. I'm the righteousness of God. Here's a new one. The indwelling Holy Spirit. Here's another one. The granted anointing. I'm granted an anointing to prosper. Here's another one, the blood. My prosperity is already paid for. The cross. Then we said, I am prosperity. I am abundance. I am increase. I am wealth. I am overflow. I am blessed. I am inheritance. All that's in my spirit already. I got to get it to come out. Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. That's 26. How many you got? Six. I'll be mad them all the week. You finally get them. Now let's go to unfolding the mysteries of prosperity that is already in you. I want to show you from three perspectives. An Old Testament perspective. A perspective of the gospel. The gospel really is not the New Testament. What? You mean you tell me that was in red? No. See, you can't walk in the New Testament until Jesus died. So I want to show you from the Old Testament. I want to show you in the gospel some things Jesus said in the gospel. Then I want to take you to a New Testament passage that's going to open the Red Sea of prosperity in your life tonight. In Isaiah 45, this is so secrets, mysteries. Here's something in these first three verses. Thus said the Lord to his anointed. To who? How many of y'all say you're anointed? You're anointed, right? Put your hand up. Go ahead, put your hand. Don't lie. Say, I'm anointed. Where your money? No, keep your hand up. I'm serious. I'm serious. I'm not trying to play no game. You see what I'm saying? That anointing supposed to produce prosperity. But you see, that soul is not your spirit. See, we're training our spirit at the expense of our soul. My spirit just like God. My spirit knows God personally. My spirit talk God language. My prosperity got confused in my soul. Even though I'm reading the Bible, even though I'm binding the devil, but until I know where the problem is and make the right correction, you will never see prosperity. You will always be going to it. Are you following me?
Yes, sir.
Say, I have prosperity right now.
Now,
I'm going to have you say something you're not going to like. I'm richer than I'm ever going to be. You already got it. So all I'm going to do and all these boys are going to do is keep you to unwrap the gift. It's a gift. It's a gift that you already have. Oh, Reverend, I don't want to go back to school. Yeah, that's what you need to do. Say something to make me shout, Reverend. Like that advertisement on TV, that man went to buy a pizza. I'm trying to turn you up like you turn that little boy up and shake that chain out your pocket. So you can get some real money. Some people got $3,000 or $4,000, really think they got some money. That's that little boy turned upside down. I'm not talking about that amount. Many preachers don't like me, but they can't stop me. And they're watching tonight. Hello, brother. Peace. Peace. Oh, they're watching. I'm still watching. I love my brethren, man. Follow me now. Follow me here in the Old Testament. Follow me. Thus said the Lord to his anointed, to Cyrus, whose right hand I have holden, to subdue nation before him. And I will loose the lions of king. That's money there. Yeah. To open before him the two leave gate. That's money. I can't explain it all. Two leave gate. And the gate shall not be shut. You know, Isaiah will talk about that further down the line. So the Gentile can bring you that stuff. I will go before thee and make the crooked place straight. Yeah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. How many of y'all got any crooked finance up here? Yes, sir. I will break in peace the gate of brass and cut in asunder the bars of iron. How many of y'all finances behind bars of iron? It's like you're in jail. You can go so far and you can't. Come on, talk to me. You can't go no further. Let's be real up in here. How many of y'all know there's more? Well, I'm preaching about more. So you might have something, a little something going, but I'm preaching about more than that. Lady told me, said she traveled a long way. Her daughter here said she was embarrassed. She was making $600 a month, but now she's making $12,000 a month. Said she had a problem, somebody messed with six figures in her money. And I think it was over $100,000. Say it was just driving. Say, but she put my tape on, let them play all night long. Say, I came out of it. You let me talk to you all night long, baby. You coming out of it. You can't be robbed while I'm talking to you. Not by no money. Notice the third verse. And I will give thee the treasures. And I will give thee the treasures of darkness. Look at the next statement. And hidden riches of secret places. You think God can do that? Remember Jehoshaphat? You remember how things looked? Five kingdoms was against it. But a man came with the word of the Lord. Jehoshaphat caught on fast. Jehoshaphat said, believe in the Lord thy God, you'll be established. Believe this prophet, we'll prosper. They whooped the army, and how many days? It took them 3 days. Your 3 days are here tonight. Understand what I'm saying. What I'm teaching you is, see, I've been through the journey. I've been through the jungle. I've been through the desert to get here. The jungle is a long way. You don't have to go through that. If I come back and tell you, I went the long way because I didn't have nobody to teach me. Many times I went the wrong way. My wife and I, not the first time we got our debt. We've been out of debt before. We worked a system of paying principal payment, but we didn't have no understanding that you can't go back and get some more and act like you're prospering. We got right back in debt. You have to come where you have so much money. Debt done took you off his list. And that's where God wants you to be. The only way you're going to understand this is a renewed mind. You're going to have to listen this week. Get your mind renewed. Leave here knowing that you're rich. And don't let no scheming preacher talk you out of it. Telling them people they're rich. I didn't say it. You want to argue with the boss? He said it. preacher at Philip Church. God is the Godfather of wealth. And I said something to make people tremble. I said, God got a mafia side of it. Yeah, I said, I read it. God will wipe you out, boy. You put your hand on the right, wrong person. It got an attack angel. Now let's hear the master teach. Go to Matthew 13. Hallelujah. Help me, Holy Spirit. Glory to God. I can't hear you. Glory to God. You stop soul persecution by revelation. Someone say, I just want to praise his name. See? I just want to praise his name. When I think about his goodness and all he have done for me, I just want to praise his name. I might not have all the money in the world, but I've been blessed. The Lord done brought me out of some things. Everybody here, the Lord has brought you out of something. Everybody here got something to shout about. We're just trying to get further in this thing. But you have seen God's hand move. You've been in a tight spot before. He got you out. You can't explain it, but you know you're out. Same way for this prosperity. Just like God healed cancer, he can cancel your debt. I want to find somebody in here, God never done nothing for you. You know he's a supernatural God. What he brought me through, I know he's supernatural. I know he can take me on to my prosperity if I let him. I know God have already made me rich. I know if I release my faith properly. We're talking about God. This is a prosperity revival. This is a money revival. That's what he told me to do. That's why you here. You ain't here just to hear hallelujah. You done heard hallelujah 90,000 times. You won't know what make this thing tick. So I'm laboring in the spirit. That the Holy Spirit, oh my God, may give you the insight to supernatural soul rest. Remember Jesus said, come unto me. You find rest for your soul. Your soul is not going to find rest until you let your spirit manifest what the Father had for you to have. One of the most unrestful soul is a broke person. You can't rest. You can't rest because you always got to be uptight about how the other thing going to happen. And you just want to get ready and say, I'm tired of this. Yes, sir. We all done travel thousands of miles to get here, hundreds of miles to get here. Yes, make it worth your time. Yes, sir. Listen, I'm teaching beyond the average here. You can correct this just like that. Just like that. Uh-huh. With the right information, the right understanding, because you got 26 activators in you. 26. I'm a kingdom citizen.
I'm a kingdom citizen.
That's prosperity.
That's prosperity.
I'm the righteousness of God.
The righteousness of God.
That's prosperity. Sit down a few more minutes. Let me teach you a little more. Lord have mercy. This Friday night and I just got paid. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Wake up in here. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus began to teach about the word which correlate with all seeds. That's money seed. All right. And when he taught this lesson, he said one or two things you need to be considered. I always like to go to this verse, Matthew 13. It's the gospel now. Matthew 13, verse 11. And the 10th verse said, and the disciples came and said to him, why speakest thou to them in parable? The 11th verse he answered to them, because it's given to you to know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven, but to them it is not given. Now watch what he said next verse. For whosoever hath, to him shall be given. And he shall have what? But whosoever hath not, from him shall be taken away even that he hath. And that's what's happening when your soul is not properly enlightened. That valve open, that the Spirit, the Trinity, become properly connected to the Trinity. The Trinity in you be connected to the Trinity of God. Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost, Spirit, soul, and body. Connection. So he said, when you understand the mystery, you can have the abundance. So you'll have more, right? All right, now, look at the 16th verse of the same opening. But blessed are your eyes, for they see, and your ears, for they hear. Now, look at Luke 24, 31, quickly. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Luke 24, 31. And their eyes were open. And they knew him. See, their eyes had to be open. Look at verse 45. Then opened he their understanding, that they might understand the scripture. See, it's got to be open. Now, I want to take you to a New Testament passage. We've been to the Old Testament, been to the Gospel. Now go to 1 Corinthians chapter 2. 1 Corinthians chapter 2. Why something? Hallelujah. Hey, Lord. Look at your lie. You got all the lie. Look, calling everybody, come alive. Hallelujah. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. No, no, we ain't going nowhere. You can feel them stirring up, boy. The wings. Now we go. Hi-ya-ya-ya-ya. Now 1 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 9. But I really feel the Holy Ghost. You know, I've been preaching about an hour, but I feel the Holy Ghost coming in here.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You know, you don't have to come the same way.
Nope.
I've had the Holy Ghost sneak up on me a lot of times.
Yes,
I'm just teaching the word, just reading the word, and almost get knocked out of my chair. I find myself weeping. Nobody doing me nothing. Just the joy of the Lord come upon me. I don't need a cry for the joy to come upon me. Get in His presence. His presence in me. I just let it out. Glory to God. I'm sensing His presence now. And I think what's happening, the word is being imparted to your soul. I think worry and fear are being pressed out of your soul. I believe something going on in you. I believe you've come to the point where you're going to walk in real prosperity this week. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I believe we'll shout later. I believe you won't succumb to lack no more. You'll be in tune with the infinite. Infinite means unlimitedness. He's an unlimited God. The more you have, the happier God be. God is never dissatisfied when His child move up higher. If it's such a thing as God clapping His hand, when one of His children hit a financial home run, God sat in the grandstand of His mercy and His grace and clapped His hand. That somebody took what I done for him. I see you walking in divine prosperity. I see worry being flushed out your soul. I see lack being flushed out of your soul tonight. Fear of not having enough must be flushed tonight. I see God working on both ends of your situation. Not only on your end, He on the other end working it. I'll never be broke another day in my life. Sometime you got to tell your soul, shut up. Get in alignment. You hear?
Yes, sir.
You see what I'm aiming at?
Yes, sir.
We can shout anytime this week and run, jump, spit. But right now I'm aiming at something. I'm putting my finger on the problem and giving the solution. You got 26 solutions. Because I'm a child of God. Because God had placed in me here His divine nature. I have the ability to call things that be not as though they are, for they are. Listen to this. Psalm 24:1. What is it saying? The world. And you mean to tell me that's my daddy? That's my father? And I'm going to go around here broke as a joke? No, baby, that's over. So wave your hand at me. That's over. But it got to be more than sweating and spitting and running and jumping. It has to be an understanding, an empowerment. It has to be an enforcement. It has to be an agreement, alignment, awareness. Here's the secret. Don't ask Him for it. Thank Him you already got it. Thank you, Lord, I'm already out of debt. Thank you, all my needs are met. Thank you, I'm rich. Thank you, I got more money than I can handle. Thank you. See, this kind of understanding, not only persecution make Jesus stand up, this kind of understanding saying thank you, because you know you already have it, made Jesus stand up again. You can't keep thanking God, all my bills are paid. You can't keep thanking God, I have my dream desire. You can't keep doing that without God, your soul opening up. Gratitude, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Say thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Gratitude is a divine wrench for your soul. In other words, you need $27,000, all right? Say, Father, thank you for the $27,000. I receive it. What? What? Lord, can you find $27,000 anyway? Have mercy, Jesus. Lord said, Lord, shut up. Lord, thank you. I need $27,000 to manifest. I receive it now. It's so easy, man. He said, I don't believe that. Well, you just sit down. You sit down. You don't believe that. You up here sucking fuel for nothing. I want you to take everything you need.
Help us.
Add it up.
Come on. Help us.
And tell him I thank you for it. I dare you. I devil dog dare you. Just add it all up. Add it all up and say, Lord, I ain't asking you for nothing. I just thank you for this $73,000. I thank you. I want to thank you. I want to thank you. I just thank you.
Hallelujah.
Come on, Apostle.
Guess what happened? Your soul will roll into cooperation. And the manifestation and the channels will start opening all around you.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
That's right.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
See, thank you mean I know it's already mine.
Yes, sir.
I got it.
Thank you mean I know I already have it.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's it.
Thank you become a manifesting scepter. The scepter of righteousness. Thank you, activate the scepter. Somebody asks, I got to close. Somebody asks, what's the limit up in here tonight? You understand?
Yes, sir.
You will not be paying for their house no 30 years, no 20 years. You will not. Just every time you think about it, Lord, thank you. Call a number out. This house is paid for. I ain't paying for no car for no 6-7 years. Lord, thank you. This car paid for. Pay your tithe, sow your seed.
Yes, sir.
Right, right. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So the enemy can't accuse you.
Yes, sir.
For stealing.
Right. Yeah, right, right, right.
Right.
She ain't paying no tithe. What she thinking about? She really not thankful?
Yeah.
She really don't trust you?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
So now, what have happened here tonight? Oh, Lord. I'm not going to tell you more. What have happened here? We have on purpose, not stumble on purpose stepped into a new, brand new way to prosperity. Look both times. You look at You're looking John 6, uh-huh. and you're looking John 11, and watch how Jesus activates things. And 1 John 5, 14 and 15.
Yep.
This is the confidence we have in him. If we ask anything according to his will, he hears. If we know he hears, yep.
we know we have.
Yes, sir. We know we have. Jesus said, I thank you. The man dead.
Yeah.
Jesus said, I thank you. You all always hear me. Lazarus, get up. You know what I heard? When I said, Lazarus, get up? You know what I heard? Money, get up. See, Jesus, the word says in the Old Testament, if you're willing... and obedient, you eat the good of the land. You know why? If you're willing and obedient, everything you ask for become willing and obedient to you. Now, in actuality and in truth, with this kind of teaching, everybody got out tonight.
Yes, sir.
No matter what thus saith the Lord,
yes, Lord.
No matter what situation,
yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
My financial freedom come tonight. Thank you, Lord. Somebody asked a question that must be appealing to you tonight. Is anything too hard for God?
Thank you, Lord.
See, because the system and your case gang up against you because it keep coming up as if you cannot move. You be going to meeting the rest of your life, you don't open your eyes. What about from behind 7 months? That's better.
Come on.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Now you'll see him. You'll see him move greater. You see.
Wow.
You seeing this? Every time you think about insufficiency or bill, you thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
We got this. Because the Lord is saying to me, I want you to move from debt to your desire.
Yes, sir.
I want you to thank me your way out of debt. So you start thanking me for your desire.
Yeah.
And then I want you to move from your desire to your dream.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Until you become a financial dominator.
Yeah.
And walk heavy. In the bank, out the bank, around the bank. Everywhere you go, walk heavy. Man said to me, Mr. Thompson, I'll bring many calls you want to. You have all of them. I'll bring them. You know why? I might buy 5 or 6.
Yeah.
Don't take a chance. Take him what he want.
Yeah.
Money talk. You can say back about, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Lord said, look, stupid. I heard you say thank you. Move on to the rest of the stuff I got for you. You down in the earth. I want you to be a blessing. I want you to walk heavy. It's religious folk. Jesus didn't have no problem with the sinners. The sinners was getting healed, getting blessed, eating bread. Because their stomach got full, fishing. There's some Christian folk. Where that bread come from? That ain't no real bread. Ain't no bread can come just like that. Where you get all that money from?
Yes, sir.
Where that money come from?
Yeah.
I've been working all my life. That's your problem. I've been working all my life, night and day. Thank you. See, all the beatitude is an attitude. Blessed are the meek. They shall inherit the earth. Blessed are the pure in heart.
Thank you.
They shall see God.
Yes, sir.
All there is an attitude, and the attitude of thanksgiving, which the Lord spoke to you tonight, and I tell you what he's going to do too. You can't say thank you in faith and be in fear. I got to close, man. Thank you overrides fear.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you slap worry out the house. I dare you try. Be sincere. In faith, say thank you. Because you know why you're saying thank you, right? Know why you say you thank you? Know why you're saying thank you? You know why you're saying thank you? You know why you're saying thank you? You know why you're saying thank you? You're saying thank you because you already got it. Oh, Lord. You know what the Lord said? Thank you is calling things that be not as though they were.
Yeah, yeah.
I just heard that in the spirit.
Yes,
when you say thank you,
yes,
you're calling what you need, those things that be not as though they were. Thank you.
Thank you.
How many seen this?
Yes.
I'm trying to close. How many seen this?
Yes.
You see it? Let me ask you a question then. How you feel when you say thank you? All right, add your bill up in your mind. Add what you need up right in your mind. And just call up and holler, thank you. Go ahead. Come on. How that felt? How that felt? It's a relief. See, you are saying thank you for something you already have.
Yes.
But thank you is unlocking it.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
My God.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I should have named this message. Thank you. What you say? And you got 27 activators to add to the thank you, I'm a son of God. Thank you, I'm the righteousness of God.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you for your word that never returned to your void. Thank you for the name of Jesus that has authority in three worlds.
Thank you for my inheritance.
Thank you. The kingdom of God is within me. And I'm in the kingdom. Kingdom prosperity. Belong to me. Thank you. I'm the head. And not the tail. Thank you. Blessings are overtaking me. Thank you. I'm blessed going in. I'm blessed coming out. I'm blessed in the city. I'm blessed in the field. Thank you. I'm the lender and not the borrower. Thank you. Hey, that means you're out of debt. Hey, that means you're out of debt.
Thank you.
I went to Darrow and got rich. Thank you.
I went to Darrow and got rich.
It don't cost too much.
Yes, sir.
What you're looking at?
Wow.
Thank you. This is not second hand information. Everything I'm preaching, Bernice, I'm living it. God did it. Thank you. Lord, I've been locked down so long. I didn't come here to this man and give me two words.
Thank you.
Thank you. Find out what you need. Find out what you want. Spend some time with him. Put your hand in the air. Say, I love you, Lord.
I love you.
Thank you.
Thank
you. Oh, Lord. It's time to say thank you.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Come on, man. Drink it. Drink it. Drink it. Drink it. We've tapped into something. Here. Drink it. Give me a minute. Drink it. 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 Theologian will argue with this, but that's all right. I've argued with theologians before. We have bumped into a shortcut. Jesus received some of the most fabulous miracles by just trusting the Father. And so he don't go to it. The guy said, what did he say? How long did he pray? Not long. All I heard him say, thank you. Man, where all this bread come from? He said, the man over there just said, thank you. Where did the fish come from? He said, well, the man over there just said, thank you. He held the fish toward heaven. He opened his mouth. He didn't say, Lord, send me more bread. He didn't say, I need more fishes. All he said was, thank you. When he said, thank you, the bread started multiplying. He said, thank you. Fish start multiplying. I'll be somebody in here ought to say thank you. Every time you say thank you, something begin to multiply. Hallelujah. I'll be, I'm going to say thank you the rest of my life. I'm going to tell the Lord thank you. Thank you. Cause heaven to come down to earth. Somebody on 5th Street said thank you. Somebody down the street said thank you. Everywhere somebody say thank you, I got to show myself strong. Because I'm a God that accept gratitude. Somebody ought to shout thank you. The Lord about to do something for you tonight. Whatever you need for him to do for you, I just want you to cry out, thank you. You've been good to me, but you're about to do something else for me. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Mary and Martha was crying. They had professional weepers with them. They were wailing, but Jesus showed up in town. And Jesus said, take me to the grave where you laid him. They thought Jesus was going to go out there and cry with them. And they thought he was going to say a long prayer. But when Jesus got to the grave, he said, roll the stone away. I know a secret that's going to cause lives to come back alive again. Oh, Lord. You can call lives back from the grave with thank you. Oh, call my debts. Paid for with thank you. When they roll that stone away, Somebody complained about how long he been dead. Jesus looked back and said, it make no difference. Thanksgiving can take care a long time. And I heard Jesus say, Father, I want to thank you. And on that cue, he said, Lyra! Oh, Lord. Did he get up? Got up bound, wrapped up. I got the clothes tonight. Jesus said, turn him loose and let him go. I'm hearing the Lord say tonight, at this prosperity revival, I'm about to turn you loose and let you go. Rise! Rise in your blessing. Rise! Rise in increase. Rise! Rise in prosperity. Rise! Rise in wealth. Rise! Somebody better take a little run forward. Take a little run. Oh, Lord. Oh. It's happening. It's happening. Go. 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 That's it, Lord. If thank you can raise a dead man, it can raise my prosperity. Thank you, I'm out of debt. Thank you, I'm financially free. It's Friday night. Everybody get paid. Hallelujah. Go ahead, man. I'm just.